Namaste, beautiful beings. This is Blender Pearl, and welcome to this weekly cosmic guiding session. I'd like to just share and see where the energy is and how it can help us all forward. I also would like these sessions that we share here together to bring like a little bit more than just insight, maybe a transmission of light, a healing, if you will. So this is my intention for you, for those that are listening and that come upon us. Whenever you come upon us, actually, will be perfect timing. But I'll give you a lay of the land so we can see where we are just in the moment. So if we look to the sky and we see the stars and the sun and the moon, we've just come out of a new moon in Libra. So new seeds have been planted about how we truly love ourselves and another. And then we are moving from sun, the sun is moving into Scorpio. So there's some parts of our being that is ready to go through this. The word is transmission, but normally we go through Scorpio and it would be like a transmutation. So there's a transmission of something that wants to come through. We have Mars in Aries, who is home and is celebrating. And what I've been enjoying, I'd say, I feel like I've been enjoying this, is Mars is over my ascendant in my natal chart. And so I've been finding this new like light in my like my inner power feels inspired to speak my truth a little bit more louder, if you will, to stand more in my power. But I think that's for everybody too. I think we all come into that space. We've been asked to stand into that hero, heroine space within inside of ourselves, that inner warrior. I like to just look towards the stars, and the stars sometimes give us a storyline. Instead of listening to maybe what everybody else in the world is saying, is to allow them to guide me. That's how I guide my life, is really just being open and aware and listening to how guidance wants to come in. And guidance normally flows in pretty freely because I'm pretty open to what guidance wishes to share. I'm done with resisting. And this is also an invitation to be done with resisting. I think this is the energy where we are right now, is the old paradigm is resisting the change, this transmutation and this transmission of light that wants to come through. So where are you on your path and how can you see your way forward? So let's bring our awareness to an intention that you feel that could benefit you. And right now, in this moment, and we ask that guidance brings some insight into whatever that it is that you're needing. So see if you can connect to your breath and your breathing. And close your eyes for a moment if that feels good. And we just call in Great Spirit, and we ask Great Spirit to talk freely through us, to guide us, to show us the way crystal clearly. Let's take another deep breath. And out through the mouth. I always like to wait for the energy to feel it. And let's see what guidance has for you and for me. And I like this. It says waterfall. And it says effortless. And so I want to always say effortlessly, like we're just moving effortlessly through life. And it's like the water finds this pathway to fall. Maybe if you're coming from the top and you don't know what's below you, it may feel scary. So we may feel like we want to like hold onto the sides of the river. But when you actually over the rapids and you look at it from the other side, is in fact beautiful. Of course, if you went over the rapids, you would be mildly, possibly bruised, possibly. But maybe there's this idea, and this is just coming in, is like when you allow your body to relax instead of tense, when we hurtling through life like a comet, and this is just coming in as guidance, if we want to take a deep breath and just soften our edges, and they say within the softening of our edges, it's like that ability to move and find the way through. Like everything has a flow. Instead of us resisting what is, instead of us letting life beat us up, it's like we can look at what's ahead of us. Instead of being resistant to it, maybe we can change our perspective. We can move to the other side and look at it from a different direction and see what it is, this easy flow, this effortless flow of the waterfall. And the waterfall brings this gracefulness to it. It reminds me of a time when I was in Switzerland and there was a small waterfall, like it was a fairy's waterfall. It was probably like a meter, 2 feet, 3 feet or so. It wasn't very tall, but it was so enchanting. And this reminds me of this enchantment, this like energy that was just so special and flowing and free. And it reminded me also of this magical realm, that's inside of us. It's like, imagine that you were a sprite, a water sprite, and you were playing in this space, playing in your perfect waterfall, your perfect garden. This is life too. This is guidance here too. It's like humans, like transport yourself into a space of what it is that you truly wish to create, the space that you wish to bring effortlessly around you. So there's this idea, I don't know why they're wishing to express it this way, but there's this idea about delight, and maybe we can envision ourselves in a new realm. People have been asking me about 3D, 4D, 5D, and it's also been coming up too. And I feel like it's like not just dimensional perspective. It's like the world that you wish to be in. It's a vibratory field. It's a field that you want to connect to. And in fact, it's part of our divine design. And nature is this divine design, even though you look at the waterfall and it's like, how was that perfection created? How is we created humanity? And we do have this divine blueprint, this beautiful blueprint to bring something forward that's in harmony with the all of the world, especially with nature and with this earth, because this is the home that we've been chosen, have chosen to bring this forward. I hope this is making sense. But there's this sense, this easiness, this flow, this water falling into place, this effortlessness. Maybe we can stop being resisting and can move into this place of effortlessness, effortlessly. I'm going to take another card and see what wants to come through. The card deck that I'm working with is an old card deck. That's a shamanic card deck. I haven't used it a lot, so I like to play with, liking to play with decks that I haven't used a lot, or if they're brand new decks, I'm kind of going into them cold turkey. Just, you know, I don't normally read the block. I like to see what the art shows me, what the feeling, the sensation comes in. If it connects with what's written in the book, that's a delight. If it's different, that's okay too, because I always feel that guidance is speaking to me through different symbols. So let us see what this deck is offering to us from a shamanic perspective. Take a deep breath in, full breath out. Let's see. Hunter of Honor. And it looks like, you know, it's some kind of animal that's moving. It's a painting on the wall. Something that we're looking for. It reminds me, in fact, just like the hands, how it is showing forward. It doesn't look like it's in battle, but it reminds me, the Hunter of Honor reminds me of this Mars positioning, this place of the inner warrior that is ready to be rising, this place too of our expression, how we want to express in the world, the direction that we are going. And it's almost like as choosing the direction that you wish to go is to making that super clear. So, but it's been moving through with this place that says honor, honoring you, honoring yourself. What is the true delight that you wish to bring through? How can we allow this effortlessness to fall into place by focusing our intentions, our attention to where it is, the direction that we wish to go? And take another card from a different deck and just see. So this is like a 3-card spread. Not that any card in any 1, 2, or 3 position has a lot to do with anything that's going on, we'll see. But it's just guidance wants to give us something a little bit extra. Let us see what guidance has here for you and for me. Oh, and this one's funny. It says skunk spirit. And I think we've seen this one before. It's 54 at the top, so it's a 9. So we're coming out of, and this is also, this is actually It's where you're pointing, the direction that you're focusing, this perspective that you hold. If you're coming from the top, it may look scary from coming that side because the side disappears and you're like, oh no, it's a waterfall. But if you shifted your perspective and you could see that there is this beautiful waterfall that's got this offering to give you, it's the same as the skunk. When it comes up, your first reaction is that, oh, the smell of the skunk. But it's telling you, the same as this warrior says, it says, know your worth. So we're coming to an end of a cycle. It's what direction that you wish to go. And if you look at this, the skunk is like balancing on a daisy, on a small flower. And just that idea of a skunk that's so small, that's standing on a flower. It's like the idea of it changes the energy of it. It's like sometimes I like to, like when I think of things that are bad, like they seem bigger than what they are. I give this analogy of, you know, it's like you think it's a big monster coming around a corner, but when it eventually arrives around the corner, it's like a tiny chihuahua, but it looked like it had big teeth. So your perspective changes, the way you see things shift. It's like how we perceive ourselves. What is it that you're perceiving? Are you having stinky ideas towards yourself? Or are you giving yourself that gift of worthiness, of loving yourself? Give yourself the direction, choose how you wish to go, and then allow it to flow effortlessly forward. Shift our perspective, that's the biggest thing. Like, seek what it is that you need to seek. Have a clear directive, and then let it all go, and let it become effortless. And it's always about how we look at ourselves, how we look at ourselves in the mirror. Like, it's end of the chapter when you don't look at yourself with a loving intention. Let us shift that energy so we can come back to that place of effortlessness with nature, our divine nature that's here to hold us, embrace us, this Eden that has us here to walk our life and to come into that part of our highest and best truth always. So hopefully that made some sense. So from my heart to your heart, may you always be blessed. Namaste. And this is Belinda Pearl. And you can always find me at belindapearl.com. If you need a reading, if you want some energy work, I do all of that online and over the phone too. So being in person is not always necessary, but I love to see you too. If you want to do things via Zoom, especially if you're in my inner circle, I want to offer each person that's in my inner circle a little lucky packet, if that makes sense, like a little like discount. So if you send me a message and you want a 30 or 45 minute reading, just send me a message and I'll give you a sweet little discount based on the energy of the day. I look forward to seeing you, hearing from you. Much love from my heart to yours. May you always be blessed. Namaste.